Welcome to the series Mastery Composer Elements. Today's video will show you in detail how to add size chart to Shopify product page. When customers shop online, especially for fashion items such as clothes and shoes, they often worry about choosing the right size. This is especially important for stores that serve customers globally, as accurate size conversions ensure a smooth shopping experience. Don't worry! eComposer is here to provide a solution with the size chart element. This feature allows you to display detailed size information for your products, helping customers make informed choices. Okay, let's start adding a size chart for your online store right now. First, go to the Shopify dashboard, select App, and open eComposer Page Builder. In case you haven't installed the app, you can find the link to eComposer on Shopify App Store in this video description. Size chart will often be placed on the product page to help customers easily choose products. So now I'm going to select my existing product page. If you don't have a product page yet, click Start Building here. Welcome to eComposer Editor. Now, select where you want to add the size chart element and drag and drop it. This is the display status of size chart element when added to the eComposer Editor. Now I will guide you to configure it. Okay, let's go to the first tab, Content. This section helps you edit all content displayed in size chart. When entering this section, General will be the first item. With this, you can choose to make the view just a button or replace it with an image. Note that, when you select an image, you can also click to zoom in on the image, similar to when you select a button view. Next is Show when match condition. You can add size charts based on conditions like all product, product tag contains, product type contains, product vendor contains, or product option contains. It helps you get the desired product to show the size chart. Remember that product tag contains, product type contains, and product vendor contains must be filled out by you in your Shopify admin. With button label, you can set a name that belongs to the button if you choose the general setting of the button style. Next is icon. This function helps you to change pick the icon that you like, change wherever you want it to be, or set the space for that icon. With content source, eComposer gives you 5 options, including page, video, video meta fields, image, image meta fields, and custom. With the page choice, you need to create a page in Shopify with the size guide content first, then select the page name in eComposer to show its content of the size chart. With video, you may choose the source get from YouTube by adding the YouTube link in the blank, Vimeo, or an external URL. Image allows you to display the image size chart in a pop-up. When you select video or image meta fields, you will be shown different size charts on each product page. Learn more about meta field in the description below. The last option is custom. With this option, you can freely create content in size chart by editing headings and content here. And the last item in the content tab is custom content pop-up. You may change the width and height for that, like whatever you expect to make it look better. Next, I'll go to the design tab. Design tab is divided into 6 sections, including general, pop-up, button, image, and heading. In this tab, you have several options to customize the appearance of your element. Okay, now I'm going to redesign this size chart to look nice. To finish editing, I need to save and publish this page. Alright, I have successfully added a size chart element to my page. Let's check it out. That is the end of today's video. Don't forget to hit the thumbs up and subscribe button for our channel. If you don't have a Shopify account, feel free to click on the link we attached in the description below. The newest Shopify exclusive deal is waiting for you. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment or join the eComposer community to get quick support and the latest updates. I'm putting the details in the description below. See you next time.